Loving greetings to you all in the sweet name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I thank our Lord Jesus Christ who has given this opportunity to meditate the Word of God with you on this day. I thank everyone who have been watching our daily meditation program regularly. I thank you for your likes, for your comments, and also for sharing it with others. I request you to continue to watch our daily meditation program regularly, and also I request you to subscribe our channel if you are not subscribed yet. The portion of the scripture chosen for today's meditation is from Acts 9 chapter verse 24 and 25. But their plot became known to Saul, and they watched the gates day and night to kill him. Then the disciples took him by night and let him down through the wall in a large basket. Yesterday I told you that God is our protection, and He gives us the divine protection that we need so that we will not be destroyed, and He is the Lord who protects us. But today I would like to tell you something more in this context, is that the Lord uses the simplest means that we use in our life also to give us the protection. So what we see here is that when there was a plot going against Saul to kill him, and there were people already watching near the gate day and night to just look for an opportunity to kill him, what we see here is that the disciples are making a plan. Then the disciples took him by night and let him down through the wall in a large basket. Took a large basket, they put Saul inside, and then from the walls they're just letting him down. And by this means he is being protected. See, God uses all the natural means for us to be protected from the hands of the evildoers. This is a natural phenomena that God is using in our lives also. One way it may be just the way that God is leading us, and how He just hides us from the sight of other people who are trying to destroy us. Another way is that He tries to totally shift us from one place to another to protect us from evil. We can see this in the life of Joseph. When his brothers were plotting to kill him because of the dream that he had, they were having anger upon him, they were feeling jealous about him, and they wanted to kill him, but he's been protected. And then they finally, we see that he's sold to Egypt. But when he goes to Egypt, that's the place where he was kept safe under God's protection, and we see that God was with Joseph. God knew that if Joseph is going to remain at the house, he's going to be killed. So when that such plot was there, the Lord shifts him up to Egypt with a plan. And that is also the plan of God in our lives also. Some shiftings in our life also is to protect us from certain evil which we do not know. When King Herod was trying to kill the Lord Jesus Christ, the angel appears to Joseph and tells him, just take this child and go to Egypt. And then they are shifted to Egypt. In such a manner, many times in our lives also, we may not know what are the things that are going against us. But God knows, and according to His wisdom, He shifts us. So He uses all the natural, simple means that are there in our life to protect us from all kind of evil and danger. And He will not allow us to be destroyed or killed until His purpose is fulfilled in our lives. So we must have this faith in our heart and trust God that He is working in our situations, and He is with us, and He is protecting us. May God bless you. Let us pray. Loving Lord, I thank and I praise you, Master, even today. Father, thank you for your word, Lord. I commit everyone who has heard the word of God, Lord Jesus, even on this day. Loving Lord, I thank and I praise you, Master. Thank you for this day. Thank you for your word, Lord. Thank you for the protections that you have given to us, Lord, even through ordinary means. You are helping us, Lord Jesus. I commit everyone who has heard the word of God, or Master, whatever they might be going through. Lord, you are the protector, and you are protecting them so that they will not be destroyed or killed. And you are keeping them safe so that your purpose will be fulfilled in the life of your children, Lord. Continue to bless them. Meet all their needs, Father. Guide them, Lord. Give them good health on this day. The divine protection, Lord. Divine guidance. And let them be a blessing to many people, Lord. Thank you because you're doing it, Lord. We give all the praise, glory, honor to Thee. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.